Hello, and welcome to User Experience Elevated, integrating Amazon with top brands. My name is Ian Bryant, and I'm the Senior Director of Strategic Partnerships here at Cedia. In today's webinar, experts in their respective fields from Amazon, Lutron, Savant, and Cedia Award winner Thoughtful Integrations will take a deep dive into technology connections you can make for your customers to craft a better user experience. First up will be Amazon, who will run through their latest home technology offerings and let you in on some features you may not have known. Lutron and Savant will follow and explain how pairing their products with Amazon enhances the user experience and could light your path towards more project opportunities. Joe Whitaker with Thoughtful Integrations will bring it all together with his firsthand experience with the three brands, how his clients like their systems, and why he uses the Cedia Propel program to enhance his business offerings. After that, we'll open up the floor for a live Q&A session. Before we begin, I'd like to ask you to visit cedia.net/propel to learn more about the Propel program, sign up to access new and innovative products, and unlock special offers like preferred pricing and other special benefits from our amazing partners like Amazon. The program is free for Cedia members, and we encourage everyone to take advantage of these special offers. We ask if you can, please spread your experience on social media and send any ideas, questions, comments, or concerns to propel@cedia.org. So without further ado, I would like to introduce Toma Hayakawa, Senior Account Representative, Amazon Devices Sales for Amazon. Thank you very much, and enjoy the webinar.
Thanks, Ian, for having me today. Hi, everyone. Welcome to our Cedia webinar. I'm excited to share this presentation with you today. My name is Toma Hayakawa, and I am a senior account representative on the Amazon Devices sales team. I manage our relationships with organizations like Cedia and distributors who serve the CI and incentive channels, along with managing our Amazon Devices sales on Amazon Business. For those of you that don't know, Amazon Business is a B2B version of Amazon.com dedicated to help businesses buy for work. It basically works just like Amazon.com with the shopping experience, with a little bit of tailored experience for B2B use cases. Today, I'll share with you how Alexa integrates with the smart home you are helping create for your customers, our offer to CDM members as part of the Propel program, and resources to help implement Alexa-enabled smart homes and procure devices on Amazon Business. So what do I mean by Amazon devices and services? You may or may not be familiar with all of our product lines. Our Echo family, which is most relevant to our conversation today, is our line of speakers powered by Alexa, our voice service. Fire is our line of tablets. Fire TV is our media player that streams video, music, and games. Kindle is our series of e-readers, where we started out as a hardware manufacturer. And we also have acquired brands like Blink and Ring that offer cameras, doorbells, and security solutions, along with Eero, our whole home Wi-Fi system that extends internet connection to every corner of a home. When we introduced Echo, Alexa only knew how to do 13 things, but we took a leap of faith without knowing the kind of scope and momentum that it would create. Now, Alexa can tell jokes, read you the news, give you reminders, and so much more. Customers interact with Alexa billions of times each week. There are currently more than 140,000 smart home products that can be controlled with Alexa. Customers are using Alexa every couple milliseconds or hundreds of times a second with their smart home devices to simplify their morning routines, take chores off their to-do list, and keep their homes safe. Customers use Alexa to control smart home devices hundreds of millions of times each week. 1 in 5 Alexa smart home interactions are initiated by Alexa without customers saying anything. That's thanks to predictive and proactive features like Alexa Guard, Routines, and one of our latest launches, Hunches. Customers have connected more than 100 million smart home devices to Alexa at this point. So let's start off with our smart home walkthrough. This past year, a lot of us worked from home or lived at work, however you prefer to describe it. This is what it is like to live with Alexa. While at home, Alexa and smart home devices help you start your day or end your day. Our goal is to make the little things simpler so you can focus on big things. Let's assume we are back to a more normal time and you're coming home from work. With Echo Auto, you can start controlling your home from your car. Alexa can turn on the outdoor lights, unlock the front door with a voice code, so on and so forth. Once you're in the living room, you can use Alexa to switch things like your lights, TV, and speakers on or off. One Alexa device can control a device at a time or multiple devices that you have set up as a routine by saying things like, Alexa, I am home. Another one that's very popular and the one I like to use is Alexa, let there be light, and it turns on all your lights that you have set up on a routine. Then you probably enter the kitchen, which is one of my favorite places in the home. I have an Echo Show 8 in my kitchen that plays music and my favorite shows while I cook. I can also see my front door when someone is there and get reminders to order groceries. I can even call my Roomba to clean up a mess. Just going back really quick, you can also do things like Alexa preheat the oven. While transitioning from room to room with your arms full, Alexa can start a list of tasks while you are on the way to your next set of chores or putting your little ones down for bed. Echo Flex is a device that can fit in even the smallest of spaces to control everything with your voice. You can also do things like Alexa call dad, Alexa turn on the lamp. No matter the size of the home, apartment, or business, the possibilities are continuing to grow. More and more products either have Alexa built in or are certified to work with Alexa. I'm sure you're wondering, at least I know I was when I joined the devices group about a year ago, what the difference between Alexa built in and works with Alexa is. Alexa built in means that you can use voice commands directly to the device since the Alexa voice service is part of the software and hardware. On the other hand, works with Alexa means that the device doesn't have any microphones or receives voice commands. An example of this would be a smart plug. You can control the device from the Alexa app or from an Alexa built-in device like the Echo Dot or Sonos speaker. In this picture example, blue products are Amazon products with Alexa built-in. The rest are a combination of third-party devices with Alexa built-in and works with Alexa products. You may have these products in your home already, which makes things really fun and interesting. Here are some of our smart home highlights from 2020. We continue to add new product security with Ring and Blink. With our new product launches in the fall, we launched redesigns of the Echo, which included a tiger design that kids love. And we have a sustainability pledge for all of our products present and future. So what's new with Alexa? We've been working on making conversations feel more natural and can now say things like talk slower or talk faster. With our Echo Show 10, which is coming soon, the device is going to be motion capable and new skills that include motion will be possible. An example would be you put it on your island and it can follow you as you move around the kitchen, making it a little bit more of an engaging experience. And with APL for audio, we now have audio mixing capabilities to let you use Alexa to mix speech, sound effects, music, and other audio at runtime on all Alexa-enabled devices. On top of Alexa getting better at conversations, expect Alexa to remember what skills you've recently used. You can expect Alexa to maintain conversations with multiple participants as well. Our other popular feature launched last year was hunches. I wanted to share with you a quick video to see how that works.
Hunches is an Alexa feature that can help you control compatible devices in your home, like lights, thermostats, and vacuums, by learning about your daily habits. For example, if Alexa has a hunch you left a light on before you went to bed, Alexa can either let you know or automatically turn it off for you. If you usually leave a certain light on, Alexa will too. Hunches make every day easier. You can give Alexa permission to take automatic actions right in the Alexa app. That means instead of turning down the heat or starting the robot vacuum before you leave for work, you can just walk out the door. Alexa can take care of the rest. Whether you have a single smart bulb or a fully connected home, it's a simple way Alexa can help make every day more convenient. Just think about all the things you won't have to think about.
Just as a person would have a hunch that something is not how it should be, for example, that you forgot to lock the door on your way up to bed, Alexa can have a hunch that a light, lock, or smart plug is not in its usual state. When Alexa has a hunch, Alexa will ask if you would like Alexa to take an action, such as turning a light off or locking the door. For example, if your back door smart lock is typically locked when you go to sleep, and one day it's not, Alexa can provide a hunch and offer to lock the door when you say, "Alexa, good night." Customers can also choose to have Alexa proactively act on hunches without having to ask. For example, if Alexa has a hunch that you're away from home or everyone has gone to bed, Alexa can automatically turn off lights, adjust the thermostat up or down, or turn down the water heater. Now let's talk about our Echo family devices and the 25% off preferred pricing we are offering to Propel members. We added 5 new products this last fall. The new products are built with 50% post-consumer recycled plastics. We've introduced Guard Plus, which is a security solution where Alexa listens for things like broken glass and alerts you. You can have voice profiles and join Zoom calls or watch Netflix from our Echo Show devices. Here's our Echo assortment and pricing in the U.S. For Propel members, we are offering 25% off of the MSRP listed on screen. Here are our line of screen devices like Echo Show 5 and Echo Show. And Echo Show 10 here on the far right is the device I was talking about that is now motion capable. We enabled discounts for Propel members through Amazon Business, which, as I shared in the beginning, is our B2B version of the Amazon.com website. You can find information about tax exemption, how-to guides, and product specifications at www.amazon.com/pro-portal. I really appreciate your time today. Now let's hear from Melissa Andresco with Lutron.
Thanks, Tuma. That was some really great information about all the magical products being brought to our customers by Amazon. As Tuma mentioned, my name is Melissa Andresco, and I'm the Chief Brand Ambassador for Lutron Electronics, and I'm going to take the next 8 to 10 minutes to take you through all the latest offerings from Lutron, and specifically how our products are integrating with those from Amazon. So let's go ahead and get started. For those of you who might not be familiar with Lutron, we have been around for 60 years, and we are known for our high quality, reliable lighting and shading control solutions. And we really put a focus on the customer. Our first company principle is to take care of the customer. And we do that by a continuous flow of innovation and bringing you new opportunities to the market so that you can build your business on lighting and shading control solutions. When it comes to integrating Lutron and Amazon products, I would be remiss if I didn't say that Lutron products integrate with a number of smart home solutions, but we are always looking for those best-in-class products, and Amazon is a true representation of one of those integrations. You can really enhance the customer experience by adding the voice component. Now, the magic of Lutron systems is that you can give your customers a lot of choice, and by choice, I mean they can control products using one of our wall-mounted remote controls. They could use the Lutron app on their mobile device, or now they can also use voice. So imagine being able to say, Alexa, turn on my kitchen light, or Alexa, set the bedtime scene. And all of a sudden your house is transforming, lights are turning on and off in select locations, and shades are raising and lowering in unison. It is really a truly magical experience and something that homeowners have really come to expect now with the smart home boom really taking off. So it's a great addition really to any home, and we're really pleased to be aligning with Amazon to be able to bring customers this type of opportunity. So I'm going to take you through four of Lutron's residential systems, all of which do integrate with the Amazon voice platform. So our first system is Caseta. Now, this is very much our entry-level system. It's a great starting point for lighting control. So if you are on a job and you notice that they don't currently have a lighting control system, it's a great place to start. It's not meant to be an entire house solution. It's really meant for key areas. And the way Amazon integrates here, you know, again, telling Alexa to turn on certain lights, and just really helping, like you see the example here, you're never coming home to a dark house. Being able to, you know, turn a light on from the app, from your car, or leaving the house lit as you're leaving, and then telling Alexa to set a certain scene as you're going out the door. So again, just a really great experience and a great way to get started. And, you know, if you're on a job and you already see an Alexa in place and they don't have lighting control, it's a great upsell opportunity. And also the reverse. If you see that an Alexa device is already there, why not add a Caseta system and get them started on this lighting control journey? The next system is called Ratu Select. Now, this is a professionally installed and programmed system, and it takes the experience to a little bit of a different level. This is meant to be a whole house solution, and it has a little bit more customization capabilities than Caseta does. For example, you've got keypads, you've got very customizable buttons on those keypads, so it's a great way to integrate Alexa, because now the button names on your keypads on your wall can match the commands that you're giving right to Alexa. So again, this is a great opportunity for an installer to get involved in lighting control, installed by the professional, but homeowners can easily make tweaks to the system, so you're not having to do multiple callbacks when the homeowner wants to change some of the lights in their system. Now, Radio Raw 2, again, very customizable, flexible, whole house solution, a little bit different aesthetics than the, again, basic Caseta system that we started with. Once again, integrates with the Alexa voice platform. Here we're integrating shades as well. So again, imagine being able to tell Alexa, you know, turn on movie time. All of a sudden, you know, shades are lowering and the lights are transforming to make the space enjoyable for whatever program you're about to watch. And then we get to our flagship system, which is called Homeworks. Now, Homeworks is really designed for the world's most exclusive homes, and the limitations are none. They're the endless possibilities that brought to you by Homeworks. It's a remarkable system, allows you to integrate every light, every shade, every device throughout the home. It's a wired solution. It also has a wireless component as well, so great for existing spaces. And again, with Homeworks, being able to easily integrate those Amazon devices so that Alexa can really simplify the commands and give those homeowners the flexibility and choice that they're craving when it comes to controlling their devices. Now, Lutron has a very special place within the Cedia and Pro Installer community. You know, like I said, Lutron has been in this business for 60 years, and we brought lighting control to the Cedia community. And a few years later, we brought shading solutions to the Cedia community. And so customers are, you're used to building your business with Lutron products. You know, we've been able to help make dealers successful for many years now, going on 30 years as being part of Cedia. And we're very proud members and proud to see so many customers building their business on lighting and shading controls. And shading controls represent, again, another great opportunity for the installer. And these can be as simple as battery-powered solutions, so no need to pull wires or have a complicated install. But if you are having a new construction project or significant remodel, of course, running power and having these wired right in is also a great option for you. And there's something very magical about telling Alexa to set a scene and watching all of these shades raise and lower in unison throughout a space. And the shade options are significant. We've got a broad range of products ranging from roller shades, Roman shades, to skylight shades, and even our new Palladium system. So again, depending on the homeowner's preference and the decor of the home, there's going to be a shading fabric that's going to be right for that space. And the integration with Amazon doesn't just stop at voice control. We also are pleased to work with Amazon on their Ring products. So Lutron products do very easily integrate with Ring video doorbells and cameras. So again, being able to offer customers now a peace of mind solution as well. We've already given them that convenience factor of being able to control lights from you know, multiple ways, including voice. But now imagine being able to give people peace of mind. So for example, the doorbell rings, one of your interior lights can turn on, or it can trigger an outside light. Let's say your camera catches a person in the detection. It can turn on select lights as well. So again, very customizable to the homeowner's preferences and whatever they're most comfortable with. You can turn on multiple lights for any one of these activities on the Ring doorbell or the Ring camera. And here's just another example of being able to turn on your interior lights when the doorbell rings. So really the opportunity between Lutron and our alliance with Amazon is significant. You know, homeowners, for starters, we're already aware of smart home devices, and it's really becoming almost expected that you're going to see some sort of device in a home now. And as a professional, imagine you being able to curate the experience for these customers, being able to understand a little bit about their lifestyle. What are their habits? You know, is this a main home? Is this a vacation home? How many people are in the house? Do they tend to, you know, work from home on a daily basis? Do they tend to, you know, entertain a lot? Learning all of these nuances of the family and helping customize and curate an experience for them is going to be just really beneficial for you as the installer. And, you know, thanks to Lutron, we have so many different products. So no matter what the home size is, the budget, or the application, there's going to be a Lutron system that's right for you. And the good news, all of them do integrate with the Alexa voice platform and also Ring cameras and doorbells. So many of you are probably already Lutron customers, and for that, we thank you. For those of you who might be new to Lutron and looking to get started or just get a little bit more information, I would encourage you to go to lutron.com/pro. And here, we're going to ask just a few very simple questions about your business today, what you're hoping to do, what you're interested in, and then a local Lutron representative will be getting in touch with you very quickly. With that, I want to thank you for your interest in Lutron, and now I would like to introduce Paul Williams from Savant and GE.
Thank you, Melissa, for the introduction. My name is Paul Williams from Savant Systems. Really pleased to be here today to talk a little bit about Savant and Alexa integration. And so, first of all, let me just start off by saying that Savant Systems is really three organizations, the Savant, GE Lighting, and Savant Energy, that come together to deliver the optimal customer solutions. And we create brighter lives and a more sustainable world. And that's the vision that we've got here at Savant. So as we talk about voice control was meant for the smart home and for home automation. It really is the thing that really helps us expose all of these great solutions that our valuable dealers are integrating into customers' homes on a daily basis. It is a way for us to be able to easily get to things like audio and video control, smart wireless lighting, bulbs and strips that are smart, our pro lighting solutions that are there, panelized lighting, the fixtures that we have, and motorized shades. And certainly, we've spent a lot of time, we feel like we've got a fantastic user interface, if we don't say so ourselves. And certainly on our apps, you can pull that up and interact with all of these products, create custom scenes that allow you to integrate them all together into one-touch solutions, which is fantastic. We also have touchscreens that do the same thing. And those are great ways for consumers to interact with those products, and even remote controls. And they do on a daily basis as well. But there are places where it's just so much more convenient to use your voice. The voice becomes a great way for me to start something or stop something. We'll walk through some examples here in just a second to get you thinking about this. But voice is really, like I mentioned, a great way for you to expose these to your customer. And so we always believe that our dealers should be thinking about that as one of the options for consumers. And we could also do the same thing with keypads, programmable keypads. You can put those on the wall and have a single button press that does that. But once again, we find that as we look at customers and the way that they interact with their smart home, is that it's not always just one way. There are various ways. Some of them are tactile, like we mentioned, but the voice plays a very, very big part of that. And since its inception and its introduction into smart home, it's been a great way for our dealers to add value to their projects. And it's something that the customers certainly recognize and realize from day one when they get those in there. Okay, for example, let's take commands that are built into Alexa, like good morning. So I can say, Alexa, good morning. And not only do I get all the built-in functionality that they have built into Alexa so that I get the weather report or I get to know a little bit about my commute today. In addition to that, we can take that key phrasing and build it into the automations that are happening inside that smart home. I can turn on the lights to the level I want them. I can raise the blinds or shades so that I'm letting in that that morning sun. In fact, I can even have that be the thing that helps me wake up in the morning. I can make sure that the lighting is set to the right CCT value to make sure that I can get ready in the morning, that I can see exactly what I've got on so that I'm not mismatched in my clothes, that is really a dark blue and not a black color that I'm putting on right now. To make sure that as makeup is being put on, that I have the best possible lighting. And that can all happen with just saying that one thing, Alexa, good morning. I can start my favorite playlist. It's going to get me pumped up for the day, get me ready to go, and get me moving. So great ways for me to be able to take in all of those things that the dealer has put in to that solution and be able to expose them very simply. Once again, I can have a button that's a button that I press that does that, and I can do it on the user interface on our app. But man, so much easier just to say, Alexa, good morning, and to have those things happen for me automatically. And we think these are great ways that we're able to now expose this investment that consumer made in their home. They spend good money on making sure that they have this great solution that has the best possible products. And what a better way to be able to show them how valuable it is than making it just so simple for them to interact with it, that it almost becomes just commonplace. In fact, people forget where they put the light switches in the home because we make it so easy for them to be able to interact with that. Another great example, Alexa, activate, I'm home. Let's turn on the television. Let's go to our favorite channels. Let's set the lighting once again in this area so that it matches what I want, or play distributed music throughout the home. These are all things that I can do, my favorite playlist, that allow me to really be able to take that solution once again and make it easy for the consumer who lives in that home to gain access to those technologies in a very simple way. So we think there's some really cool things that you can do here. And I'll mention here, this is what, in this case, what we're doing is we're taking our scene functionality. So within Savant, we have these scenes, and those scenes can really be programmed to do pretty much anything that you would want to do in a smart home. And I can then add on that automation that exists attached to that scene. So anytime that scene is activated, I can have numerous things happen. Anything that could be automated in the home can follow that scene. So a great way, once again, for you to be able to, as a dealer, to be able to add this functionality onto the home for your consumers. And it's an added benefit that we find as we talk to consumers, they find valuable at the same time too, which is even more important. How about another one says, Alexa, activate entertain. And entertain is a scene that I've got. And now we make this area fun. We've taken all of the power of the lighting solutions that we've created to create this great infinite color experience for a consumer so that I can make the area like fun and inviting. Also make sure I'm playing the playlist that's gonna get my guests to be in the best possible mood, whether that's to get them hyped up or I want a nice calm evening at home with some cocktails as we get into the post-COVID world and get back into entertaining. Some of us will have to remember how we did that in the first place. We'll have to recreate that, and we'll be some social awkwardness as we figure out how to entertain again. But being able to have that home do that once again instantaneously for that consumer, get to the right lighting settings, get to the right volume of audio being played in those areas, and to not have to then sit in there and tweak that manually every time I want to do that, to have that happen, is really kind of a is really a great opportunity for you to add value for that consumer, and a great way for them to then be able to experience the smart home that you've created. And then when it comes time for the evening and it's time to say goodnight, a lot of customers and consumers take what I call the Better Homes and Gardens tour of their home every night. And I think all of us do it, whether we realize it or not. Well, those of us that don't live in smart homes, because I live in a smart home, and so I have this capability, is that you have to walk around, you have to go figure out everything that was left on during the day. There's Xboxes and PlayStations and televisions and music and lights, and you name it, it got left on. No one can ever remember. If there's more than one person that lives in the house, I can guarantee you no one will remember who left on those things, or at least cup up to the fact that they're the ones that left it on. And so you find yourself having to walk around the home and turn these things off. Well, in a smart home and in a Savant home, that is well integrated along with Alexa, all I have to say is Alexa, good night. And not only will once again, we're keying into some of these key functions that Alexa has, I will say good night, but I can also set an alarm for myself to wake up in the morning. That can happen. But in addition to that, I can have the smart home shut itself down. I can make sure that all the lights get turned off. And I can make sure that any audio or video that was left on during the day is turned off. So that's all turned off. I can lock doors that are in the house. I can make sure that the garage doors are shut. These are all things that I can do once I'm leveraging that Savant smart home to turn these off. So as I would look at, you know, what are the things that you need to do as you think about, you know, this Savant home that's integrated with Alexa, I would say let's look at anything that makes sense for the consumer that would be easy for them to get access to. Lighting is a key thing for consumers. It's also a thing that works nicely for you to be able to execute these scenes in particular that say, I want to get in this mood, or I want to have it this is how I want the home to feel. Those are things that then can be done through voice that are very simple. But also those things that we mentioned that always pop up at the top of the list, good morning, good night, I'm home, I'm leaving, are all things that we would recommend. Those kind of four things that are there all the time for consumers. And I would build those in for the consumers that want to have voice control, and then have them be able to then have you add on things that may make sense as they expand those out and get a feel for if they're new to smart home and new to home automation. As they start to explore and understand what the capabilities are, they can expand out what those experiences are. But don't be afraid. We find it's really easy to integrate. I think that Amazon and Alexa have done a great job in building out their capabilities, making it easier for us to get the skills in there that allow us to have that kind of control. And it's something that we believe is a valuable part of any Savant system that's out there. If you want to learn more about our Savant integrations and more about Savant, you can always come to savant.com. We're always happy to talk to dealers about their install needs and about how we build their future. I'd like to turn the time over to someone who almost doesn't need an introduction. He and I have worked a lot together in the past. I admire his work and what his company does, especially in our industry here in the CEDIA world. And I want to introduce Joe Whitaker from Thoughtful Integrations. Joe, it's all yours.
Thank you, Paul, for that amazing and humbling introduction. I do want to say thank you to all the previous presenters, Melissa with Lutron, Toma with Amazon, and of course, Paul Williams with Savant. Now, I'm going to dive right into the effects of our business, right? Because at the end of the day, that's what we're doing, right? We're trying to make money. So talking about voice, Propel, and the bottom line as it pertains to your business. So just to give you guys a little background, on the voice side and integration, we've been doing this long before Alexa was around and some of the other brands that we're used to now. But as you start thinking of voice, you need to think about the different parts of your business. We've used Alexa and the Echo Dot to actually, you know, enrich our marketing, whether it was through skills, or dropping off dots that were branded for us in specific zip codes and area codes, down to looking at those ring neighborhoods, right? There's actually ring neighborhoods now where the whole neighborhood is all about ring, actually reaching out to them about, you know, upgrades, future proofing, and other technologies that work with ring. And I've also been deep in the design phases with manufacturers building things to kind of complement what Alexa does, or, you know, some of the other brands. Integration, that's like one of our key points, is we know the consumer market and the needs and the wants when it comes to voice control. But voice isn't it, right? It's got to control all the other important things, whether it be your music, your lighting, your shades. You have to tie all these things in together. So, you know, one of the things CD has done pretty good teaching integrators about is, you know, that difference between, you know, cloud, fog, local, where does control sit? So one of my biggest pieces of advice to all integrators out there when you're dealing with voice control is the programming that goes behind it. So say it's like the lighting scene, all the lighting of the Lutron lighting and the shades in your hearth room or your main living area. Set those scenes or custom macros or, you know, complex group programming inside the system itself, whether it be Lutron, Savant, or others. Set that programming inside your actual control system, because this allows you, when you have an internet lossage, because Alexa deals with cloud, or an update, or any of those things that can break that voice command, you need to have it locally. So they still have a press of a button or a press on a user interface, a phone, an iPad, etc., where those scenes they're used to, that they wake up in the morning to, that they go to bed with, that they come home from work with, or they turn on sports. So they still have access to them, even when the internet goes down, even when voice devices are in updates or cloud services are down. Need to keep those local. And as you program those, you need to have your button. They all need to be a single button press does everything, whether it be on a UI, a keypad, or other forms or functions of a remote. Within your system, create those single button press so that that visible device is visible inside, you know, an Amazon Alexa, the Alexa app. So it sees it as one device that does your entire macro, your entire scene, or your complex grouping for your programming. This is important so that when you go into, like Alexa, the routine, Toma mentioned this during his presentation, routines. Routines are your kind of your key point with your consumers, with your clients, because, you know, a lot of times when you do your standard programming within Alexa, you have to say, you know, turn on or off. Routines get you around that, allows you to just say, Alexa, good morning. And then all of those things that you've attached through that single button press inside a routine, they can all happen with a very user-friendly word. So now I'm going to jump on to a little bit about CD of Propel and how the numbers just, they really kind of make sense if you break them down into what it is. And a big thank you to, you know, Amazon Ring and the other early joiners that came on to start the Propel program. And also, you know, the new ones in the future, there's going to be some cool ones. But it's interesting that, like today's webinar, you have very big brands that we as integrators have known for a long time, like Savant and Lutron, really teaming up with a company like Amazon and Ring that is now really helping us to propel our businesses forward. So Propel is not just all about the money that you realize, right? It goes much deeper into, you know, the access to converging and emerging brands, exposure to new technology, and even new lead generation. Within our company, our historical conversion rates are about 2%. I know that's really low for these manufacturer referral programs. It's not their fault, though. I want you to realize this. The big thing is the why. It's like most potential clients, they see the banner ad pop up, whether it be on Instagram or Facebook or even LinkedIn, and you see that ad. We've all seen those ads. Home automation starting at $1,000. They're like, oh my gosh, I could do lighting control, music, and TV control all for $1,000. And then they call the manufacturer. The manufacturer gives you a lead, and then you call them. And they're expecting all of this for $1,000. And then you're like, yeah, that'll get you like a remote and a controller, and we can control a little bit of your AV. But then lighting is this, and this is that, and this is that. The lead expectation was broken right at the start, just by how it was created. And of course, this leads to those dead leads. Now I want to give an example that I was exposed to through Propel. I was not on the Amazon Pro program, the Amazon for Business platform. I wasn't on the Ring Pro program yet. This was all exposed to me through Propel as Propel launched. So our current conversion rate with Ring is right about 90%, just slightly higher than 90. I add to this that of those converted, about 40% tend to do add-ons. And these are of integrator-grade equipment, whether it be networking, where you need, you know, quality switches and quality network to run a bunch of Ring PoE cameras, don't you? It goes to audio, whether they're adding something like Sonos or other products, and they get exposed by us to things like Savant and Lutron for lighting control, for those easy tie-ins. But the why, right? So why is this conversion rate different from what we're used to from our custom segment manufacturers? Well, number one, when that lead comes in, they've already been exposed, right? They already know Amazon. They already know Ring. These are, you know, brand names for them. And when they go to Amazon and they want PoE cameras or other devices, doorbells, or a really cohesive experience with Alexa, they've already been on Amazon's site, right? They've already been on Ring's site. They're already going to buy. Now comes the point where they realize they don't have the technical skills or the knowledge to choose the right products and the other products that make it work together. So the sale has already been made. Thing to realize, they're already buying. And the other thing is on it, they've already done all that research. They know the prices, right? They know that this is a retail price. And they know from other advertising from Ring and Amazon that the pro versions cost this. The pricing is already out there. They know they want it. They know what the price is. Now they're looking for the professional, the certified individual to do this. And, you know, that kind of comes down to the impact. And this is where, you know, I will just, you know, break it down into your integrators, just like me. I know many of you. I've always worked my hardest to support us all. So this is my point of realization for you. Do you like money? Like, seriously, you know, you've got to get out of your own way sometimes to increase qualified business leads and in a revenue generation scheme that you might have not looked at before. I have been as guilty as most, where my nose is up in the air and my ego's in my way. And I say, no, I only do these multi-million dollar houses. I only do, you know, $100,000 over home theaters. Okay, great. Would you like six of those theaters a year, or, you know, 100 or 200, you know, $2,000 to $5,000 jobs that came through Propel? I mean, think about that. You're talking about hot and fast. They come through, they're ready to roll. Products are simple to install. The users love the experience with this. Where's the problem at? You know, this is a business impact. Of course, it is a technology impact because you can integrate it with things with Savant, Lutron, and others. But this is a very easy way to impact your business. So as Propel grows, you'll see more brands just like this, just like Amazon. You'll see other entries. These are new ways for you to generate revenue. And right now, what Amazon and Ring is doing with this program, I can tell you firsthand, personal experience, it has been a great business impact, but it's also been an eye-opener into new products, new technologies, and new ways that we can create revenue, because I let my ego kind of push that guy out of the way, got my nose out of the clouds. And I said, why am I in business? Of course, it's amazing to do award-winning technology for our consumers, but it's even better to have more money to support the families of our employees, to support my family, to support our business. And at the end of the day, that's what Propel is all about, propelling your business. So take a seat back, go back, look at the Propel program. Go check out the Amazon for Business program, because you can get other things on there as well. Just letting you know. I'm Joe Whitaker. I'm going to pass it back over there to Ian, who's going to close this one out. I hope you all check out these great brands. I want to thank Amazon, Lutron, Savant for breaking down your brand, your products, your services, and how all work together with voice control over Alexa. And Ian, go ahead and take it away.
So we're going to do a live Q&A. I don't see any questions that have come in from the audience. If you do have a question, please post it in the Q&A section. I personally have a question specifically for Melissa and Paul in regards to user interfaces, and wanted to get some input on from my background in control systems is what is the recommendation on diversifying and having diversity in your user interface options, like not sticking with just a keypad or just a touch panel, but then incorporating voice control, and so that you have a diversity in your ecosystem and a system as a whole. And I think Paul had to leave. So Melissa and Tuma.
Yeah, I can start. Thanks, Ian. So the diversification is really important. And, you know, like I showed in the slides earlier, we give our consumers a lot of choice. So sometimes, you know, using your voice isn't practical to turn on the lights. Sometimes you don't want to have to go to your phone and pick up the app and go through to turn on your lights. You know, sometimes it's just easier to use the Lutron Pico wall-mounted control. So, you know, we talked a lot about the personalization and the customization of these systems. So by giving people, you know, a wealth of choice, they're going to be able to, you know, use the interface that's right for them. And typically what we see is that it usually is a combination of all three, and it's just really application dependent.
Thank you. That's awesome. Yeah, I agree as well. When I first started getting into the industry back in the late 90s, early 2000s, it was all about big giant touch panels in every single room. And I think we finally, you know, when Amazon came out with the Echo product line and started to realize that, you know, there needed to be some more options besides just huge touch panels or mobile devices. Though there was, I think, a little bit of a time where everyone thought voice would be the only interface it would just take over it all. But we're all, I think, finding that good equal ground where it's a mixture of everything.
And you want to think about your visitors too. You know, if you have house guests, you want them to be able to turn lights on in a familiar way. So they're going to typically be looking for some sort of wall control. So it's really thinking through not just the applications, but the different types of users as well.
Absolutely. Toma, going back to the question that Walt had regarding the hunches, is there and you may not know, but is there like a plan for advancing like that program? Is this just the beginning and it's looking like there's a way to for that it's going to continue to grow and get the hunches are going to become more used and as AI develops and the processing capabilities are there. Do you have any insight on that?
Yeah, I think it's just like, you know, when we first launched with Alexa, right? We take a leap of faith. We, you know, launch with something that's probably, you know, a small kind of in scale and see how it goes and learn from the experience and then just keep expanding from there. One thing I wanted to clarify is it does work already today with third-party lights, locks, smart plugs, and switches, and even thermostats. So, you know, to answer Walt's question from earlier, it's already working with all these products that are both Amazon built and Ring built and others as well. So, you know, already kind of progressing in that space. I expect that over the next few months and years, it'll just be more and more prevalent throughout the experience.
Thank you. And then Melissa, I didn't know if you had any use cases that you've heard of, any unique scenarios of any like Lutron dealers incorporating this in, or any We're seeing it in MDUs or just didn't know if there was any special situations that we've seen any integration between the two.
You know, I think two things. So number one, I think, you know, like I mentioned in my presentation, you know, it's a great way to build a business, right? So if an installer sees that there's an Echo device in the home, it's an opportunity to add Lutron. If a dealer is adding Lutron to the space, it's a great opportunity to add voice. And, you know, being able to offer your customers just so many unique use cases, and it's just so customizable, you know, telling your Alexa to turn on relaxing time, you know, you're going to have your favorite, you know, perhaps music come on in the space or the lights dim to a certain level. So for us, it's really about seeing the unique, you know, use cases when it comes to customization and all the different, bringing together multiple different of our integration companies and just creating that really curated experience in the home.
Absolutely. Walt, did you have something you want to add into this conversation?
Yes, I do. And this is kind of to everybody. And this goes back to UI again. And I think UI is so important. And one of the things I'm a little concerned about, and I'm curious if everyone thinks this is, I'd like to hear your thoughts on it, but being a guy that's pretty involved in standards and recommended practices, it seems to me like it would behoove us to have an effort where we could do a recommended practice on voice control. For instance, when Melissa talked about, you know, you have guests in your house, everybody's voice control is likely set up completely different than everybody else's. So it's easier in many cases to hit that button. But if the button isn't there and there are microphones, what's the phrase? What do you call the kitchen light? What do you call the kitchen audio? I'm curious from everyone if what your interest is on that, because I'm thinking about it hard. Crickets.
Go ahead.
I was just going to say, I mean, I know that I know we've been working on that. There's the placement of your microphones, the naming convention, everything else. I believe everyone's been a little bit timid to try and tackle that. I know, Walt, you tried to do that with a white paper last year, and it was very difficult because it's still so new. Even though voice control has been around for a while, it's now like only recently has made it into mass adoption of, you know, over the past 6 to 12 months of getting into the majority of people's homes. But I definitely, you know, it's something that we need to work on for sure.
Melissa, you were going to chime in there.
Yeah. So, you know, I think this is why it's so important to have the relationship between the integrator and the homeowner so that the integrator can truly understand, how do you use your home? Do you call it the family room? Do you call it the TV room? So that the language that the installer is setting up is familiar to the homeowner. So starting with that baseline understanding of, you know, what do you refer to each room as? I mean, I think that's why these relationships are so critical. It's, again, it's all about this customization and, you know, these curated experiences. So a simple yet, you know, logical first starting point is really for those two to have that conversation and understand, you know, what those room names are so that you're starting off already with familiar vocabulary.
Yeah, I totally agree. And it is a larger thing because we're all global companies. So the name kitchen could be, I mean, you know, you take it from there. It's just trying to do a global effort.
Exactly.
All right. Well, I really appreciate everyone. Toma Hayakawa from Amazon, Joe Whitaker, Melissa Andresco from Lutron, Paul Williams from Savant, and always, as always, Walt Zerbe, thank you very much. Thanks, everyone, for tuning in. If you have any questions regarding Propel and the program, please visit cedia.net/Propel. I'm Ian Bryant, and thanks, everyone, for joining.
Thank you, everyone.